So this second thing is swadhyo yenad bhuta madhurima. He wanted to know, understand the wonderful sweet qualities in him that Radharani relishes, that she tastes. And that's also mentioned in this Chaitanya Charitamrita, Nadi Lila, chapter 4. There's a nice reference, verse 139. This book is really quite wonderful, Chaitanya Charitamrita. This further elaboration on this same verse. Or Krishna is saying, he's speaking here, further elaboration. That was in the beginning of the chapter, and then later the verses are more elaborated. Vishaya jatiya sukha amara aswad amahaite koti gun ashrayar alad. Like pralad, alad. Krishna is saying, I taste the bliss to which the object of love is entitled, but the pleasure of Radha, the abode of that love, is 10 million times greater. So Krishna is saying, I'm the enjoyer, and Radha is the enjoyed. I'm the Vishai, the subject, and Radharani is the object. She's the Ashray. I'm Prem Vishai, and she's Prem Ashray. So she is trying to do everything to please me and satisfy me, and not considering anything for herself. But I'm observing that the pleasure that she's deriving by the Alad, or by just dedicating herself to me absolutely and unequivocally, she's actually deriving 10 million times greater pleasure. So what Krishna is saying here is that the servant of the Lord, that the one who's serving the Lord, he's getting 10 million times more pleasure than the recipient of the service. Well, this is quite astounding. If you ask the slaves in America during the slave, when they're rowing the boat, are you getting 10 million times more pleasure than the captain who's whipping you with his whip in the Greek days, as guys would, slaves would be under the hold of the boat, rowing the boat or something? Oh yes, I feel like I'm getting 10 million times. No, the Krishna is saying this, and then he says, Ashraya jatiya sukha payate manadhai jatne ashwadite nari kikari upai. He's saying, Krishna's saying, my mind races to taste the pleasure experienced by the ashray, the abode of love. But I cannot taste it, even by my best efforts. How may I taste it? You know, it's like I see that you're eating some ice cream. So Krishna's telling that my mind, I see that Radharani, I see you eating all this ice cream, and you're saying, and I'm thinking, my mind is thinking, oh, it seems like you're having a good time. You're enjoying that ice cream. So my mind has become attracted, and my mind is racing. Oh, how are you experiencing that ice cream? But how can I taste it? I can't taste it. My mind is thinking and understanding and appreciating what experience you're having from tasting that ice cream. And I'm also very interested. But how can I taste it? Unless I become you and eat that ice cream, how can I taste it?